What are your thoughts? You like Daniel Jones a lot. You have it for a long time. Who do you think is right for this job? What's the type of resume we're looking for here?
Yeah, I don't know. And it's interesting that you mentioned, you know, some of these college guys. I get it. And if they do that, bring in like a Wade Phillips to coach that defense. That's why it worked with the Rams with Sean McVay.
Yeah.
He was smart enough to understand, hey, a lot of these young guys are intimidated to hire great coaches.
Yeah.
All right? This guy can't be. Whoever gets that job has to hire great coaches. It's not that they're going to bring an offensive guy in.
Right. It's very odd listening to you talk about it from that perspective, because a name that would come to my mind, someone who can work in New York that could be that great defensive coach to help out that offensive guy, is somebody like Rex Ryan, who also understands, like, I like the idea. I know people are critical of going after guys who've already had coaching jobs as retreads, but that experience is critical, and I think it helps for them to understand how to rebuild an organization.
Well, and we've seen some guys without experience fall short. Of course, Freddie Kitchens also let go by the Browns today. I want to ask you about Gettleman in this situation, because he received a lot of criticism when he drafted Daniel Jones, and he was right. Look, I mean, he's nailed it on the draft. Daniel Jones, Saquon Barkley, feels like Gettleman's in a good position here as well.
Yeah, I think David Gettleman has the opportunity to go, I told you so. I was right with my pick of Daniel Jones. That matters. You know, now they've got to go make a draft pick again this year at number four. That'll be important. Matt Rhule, they should not allow Matt Rhule to say no. This should not be hard. This is the Giants. This is a good organization. This is a well-run organization with great ownership. Do not allow Matt Rhule to say no. I think Dave Gettleman has earned the opportunity to continue to make picks for another year for this football team, because he got the most important one. At least right now, it looks like he got the most important one right.
Now I'm starting to disagree with you. I'm not sure about this whole well-run thing, and I'm also not sure about Daniel
Jones. The Giants
Jones.
Are a well-run organization.
I don't know about that. Aren't they also the organization that has, like, the brother of the owner participating in making draft day decisions? Like, let's cool it on well-run organization. But I do think it's a good job, and I also think that I'm not sure on Daniel Jones. I know you guys love him, but you also loved Mayfield at the end of last season, and I'm not sure right. that I'm not sure. About
but you
that
have to be inspired by his performance.
Oh, yeah,
you have to feel good about
it. It's not the same as some other quarterbacks where you know that it's
let's bring
over.
Dan Graziano in here today, because we have the luxury of having an NFL insider as well to talk about this.
Rolling
so what are you hearing about? Yeah, roll your chair in. What are you hearing about all this, and just your thoughts on Gettleman, Shurmur, of course, being let go by the Giants, as reported by Adam Schefter?
I think Dominique's point is really important. When you talk about a coach coming into a situation, they're going to want to know what the front office structure is like. And if you're keeping Dave Gettleman, it reeks of what they did a couple years ago when they kept Jerry Reese and hired Ben McAdoo, and that turned out to be a huge disaster. There are concerns about the way the Giants are set up with regard to being a family operation, and that's not going to change. So you're going to have to get somebody who's comfortable with that, and that might turn off some candidates. So the Giants are going to do things the Giant way. We know that for a fact.
Yeah.
And they're going to get a coach that fits that.
All right, let's get to Adam Schefter, who's joining us now. Of course, just breaking this news that Pat Shurmur would be let go by the Giants. What are you hearing, Adam, the latest here with the Giants?
Laura, no surprise here. The Giants quietly have been doing due diligence on coaches to see the potential candidates that have been out there in the field in the event that they decided to make the move that they did this morning, letting Pat Shurmur go after two seasons. Keep in mind, this is the Giants' third head coaching search over the last 5 years. So they've been through this quite a bit here over time, hiring Ben McAdoo, hiring Pat Shurmur, and now once again being on the search for a new coach. I think the men that you will look at, the name Matt Rhule automatically comes up. He's somebody that is said to have an interest in being back in New York, somebody that would be a candidate for that job. Keep in mind, 2 years ago, the Giants interviewed Josh McDaniels, the Patriots offensive coordinator. And at that point, they had some real interest in him at that point in time. So those are two names right off the bat that you would figure would have some sort of interest to the New York Giants. Josh McDaniels, Matt Rhule. We'll see where they decide to go with this particular search. I'm sure, I know, there will be other candidates for the job. It will not just be those two names, but those would be two names of interest for the Giants' job with the move that they made this morning, dismissing Pat Shurmur as the head coach.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports, more analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+. We'll see you there.